ओके सो टुडे वी विल बी स्टडिंग अबाउट कॉम्पोजिशन ऑफ लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। ओके सो सपोज इफ आई हैव टू लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, वन इज फ्रॉम वी टू डब्ल्यू एंड आई हैव अनदर विच इज फ्रॉम डब्ल्यू टू अनदर वेक्टर स्पेस जी। आई एम अज्यूमिंग वी W and Z to be vector spaces over same field F. Okay, so the field here is same for V, W and Z. Then composition, like we do composition of normal maps. So again here the composition would be UT from V to Z. Okay, so this is my composition. I have to first show that this composition UT, if this is linear, then UT is also linear. Okay, so this is the first thing that we have to show. This is very easy. I'll be just using the linearity of T and U, and I will get UT's linearity. Okay, so what we have to do is, since I need to show that UT is linear, I need to show that UT of cx plus dy is equals to c ut of x plus d ut of y. Okay, so I'll be starting off with LHS. So here I'm starting off from here, so I get ut of this is nothing but ut of cx plus dy. Okay, now because t is linear, so this entire expression becomes c t of x plus d t of y. Okay, now because u is linear, all right, so this entire expression becomes c u t x plus d u t y. So I've just used linearity of u and t, and I see that I get this. After this step, I get this. I hope it is clear to all of you. If there is any problem, you can unmute and ask. Else, we'll move on. If there is anybody, any problem, please unmute and tell me. Okay, so composition is clear to you. Since after doing composition, if you remember, when we did T as a linear transformation, we represented it using a matrix corresponding to that linear transformation. So now what I'm doing is, now that I've shown that UT is linear, I want to find out what would be the matrix of UT. All right, let me just recapitulate once again. T was from V to W, U was from W to Z. So there are three vector spaces V, W, Z. Now, because I have to talk about matrix of these linear transformation, I'll have to assume that all of these vector spaces are finite dimensional vector space. So they have a finite basis. I'm assuming V ka basis is alpha, W's basis is beta, and gamma is the basis for Z. So if alpha is a basis for V, beta is a basis for W, T is linear, then the matrix would be given by T alpha beta. Okay, similarly, U, since the domain is W, so here I'll have beta gamma. Now, what is UT? UT is from V to Z. So the matrix representation would be given by, domain is V, so alpha gamma. Okay, we need to find this out. So the next theorem basically says that this matrix is nothing but the matrix of U into the matrix of T. Now, what is the matrix of U? It is beta gamma here. So beta gamma. For T, it is alpha beta. It was alpha gamma here. Please do not get confused. This is domain and this is codomain. So when I am bifurcating, so I'll get domain and codomain. Domain and codomain for whatever linear transformation that I'm taking. All right. So this is what we have to prove. All right. We have to prove that the matrix of UT is nothing but matrix of U into matrix of T. All right. So how do we do that? For that, we assume alpha to be V1, V2, Vm. Okay. We take beta to be W1, W2, Wn. And then we take gamma to be Z1, Z2, Zp. Okay. So I've taken these three bases. Now, if I want to find out the matrix of UT, what is matrix of UT? What do we do? So alpha is the basis for domain. All right. अगर मुझे किसी भी लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन का मैट्रिक्स निकालना है सो पहले हम क्या करते हैं वी फाइंड आउट द इमेज ऑफ द बेसिस ऑफ डोमेन राइट जैसे हम अगर टी का निकालते हैं तो हम पहले क्या करते थे वी यूज टू डू टी अल्फा राइट डोमेन का जो बेसिस है उसका इमेज सो सिंस आई नीड टू फाइंड आउट द मैट्रिक्स ऑफ यू टी सो आई नीड टू फाइंड आउट यू टी अल्फा All right, and UT alpha would be what? UT V1, UT V2, UT Vm. So in general, my jth column of UT alpha gamma is what? It is UT Vj. Okay, k coordinates with respect to gamma. This is my jth column. All right. So I am now trying to find out what UT Vj is. All right. So let us see. So UT Vj. I am just trying to find what UT Vj is. So UT Vj is nothing but U of T Vj. All right. Now, again. What I am doing here now is I have to use matrix of T and then I'll have to use the matrix of U also. So let us see. So what I'm doing right now is I'm assuming that matrix of T is A and I'm assuming matrix of U, which is beta gamma here, is B. Okay, so I'm assuming matrix of T is A, matrix of U is B. So if I want to write the jth column of this, it would be written as what? It would be written as T V J coordinates with respect to beta, right? This would be my jth column. So that means if I want to write down what T V J is, forget about coordinates. So if I want to write down what TVJ is, what will it be? It'll be summation K going from 1 to N A K J. So because I've taken matrix to be A, all right. So the jth column basically is the coordinates of each of W K's, right? Is this clear, everyone? I have assumed, I'll just repeat it once again. I have assumed A to be the matrix of T. All right. Now, matrix of T, if I want to find out the jth column of this matrix, it will be TVJ with respect to beta. All right, the coordinates of TVJ with respect to beta. Now, what would be? Now, beta means what? Beta is W1, W2, Wm, or Wn. All right, so TVJ ke coordinates with respect to beta, yani ki jo mere coefficients aa rahe hain, W1, W2, Wn ke. All right, so TVJ kya hua? TVJ ho gaya. So my jth column, if I want to write down, it will be A jth column. A1J, A2J, and up till ANJ. ऑल राइट right? और ये है क्या, दिस इज द कोफिशियंट ऑफ डब्ल्यू वन, कोफिशियंट ऑफ डब्ल्यू टू, कोफिशियंट ऑफ डब्ल्यू एन. सो टी वी जे इज सम ऑफ ऑल ऑफ दीज, राइट? सो दिस इज वॉट आई हैव रिटन. इफ देर इज एनी प्रॉब्लम, एनी वन ऑफ यू हियर प्लीज आस्क, अनम्यूट एंड आस्क. So it's okay. So now here I get UT of VJ is equal to U summation A K J W K. All right, K goes from 1 to N. Now because U is linear, all right, so from here I get summation K goes from 1 to N A K J U W K. Okay, so U W K. Now again coming back to this here. Now to find out the matrix of U with respect to beta gamma, we first find U beta. All right. So beta is W1, W2, Wn. All right. And so here my kth, because I have taken W K. So basically U W K will be the kth column of B. All right. So this coordinates with respect to gamma will be my kth column of B. All right. So that means again, jaise aise kiya tha, waise hi U W K would be summation of B. Again, this is kth column. Okay. So B 1 K. Kth column B 2 K B how many W how many will I get here? It will be B P K. Why P? Because these are corresponding to gamma coordinates with respect to gamma, and gamma contains P elements. All right, gamma was Z1, Z2, ZP. All right. So this is what, this is B I K I going from 1 to P. All right. And Z I. Is this okay? Jaise ye tha, bilkul waise hi kiya hai. There is nothing more that I've done. All right. So if there is any problem, anyone, I will just write it here again neatly so that you understand. I've written U W K is equals to summation I going from 1 to P B I K Z I. This is what I've written. Anybody, any problem, please unmute and ask. Okay. So now I'm putting this value here. So I get again from here, I get U T of V J is equal to summation K going from 1 to N A K J summation I going from 1 to P B I K Z I. Okay. So now I'm just rewriting this entire thing because here I want, here look, this is Z I and this summation is running over I. All right. So I'm just taking this out and taking this inside. So summation I goes from 1 to P. All right. So now that I do this, I get summation K goes from 1 to N B I K A K J. All right. Z I. So this is what I get. All right. So I'm just putting a bracket here as well. So now when I take this summation B I K A K J K going from 1 to N. All right. So what do I get? I get this to be. Ye kya hota hai? Jab hum product lete hai. When we take product of B into A. All right. B into A. So what is this? Is this not? What is this? This is B I K. A K J. So B I K A K J. So this is C I J, right? Product mein, this is Cij. When I do B into A, I get this to be Cij. Is this okay? Everyone? Okay. So I'm just putting this here now. So I get UTVJ is equal to summation I going from 1 to P Cijzi. Okay. So now just see here. I was supposed to find out UT alpha gamma. Okay. So alpha was my domain ka basis and gamma was codomain spaces. So I found out UTVJ. All right. Now if UTVJ is this, that means UTVJ ke coordinates with respect to gamma. Gamma is Z1, Z2, Zp. All right. So it is what? It is what is this? This will be the jth column. All right. So C1J, C2J, CPJ. All right. So this is jth column of UT. Okay. So that means jth column of UT is equal to. Ab ye Cij kiske equal hai? C1j is what? What is C1j? Everyone, please unmute. So now jth column of UT, can I not write this as jth column of U into jth column of T? Cij is aaya na mere paas. Or instead, jth column of UT, yahi se, instead of writing this, you can straight away write because jth column is coming out to be C1j, C2j, CPj. Iska matlab kya hua? UT is coming out to be, from here you can write down UT alpha gamma is coming out to be C. Alright? And here we had written Cij is this. So what does that mean? This means that C is B into A. So that means UT is U into T. So alpha, beta, beta, gamma. All right. This is what we were supposed to prove. I have just used the definition of multiplication of matrix. Hum matrix ko multiply kis tarike se karte hain? We do it this way. Okay. So if I have two matrices, so we multiply it this way. So this is what is happening here. Okay. So we see Cij jo hai, that is obtained from here. All right. So that means that the jth column of UT is in terms of Cj's only. Right. So that means jth column of UT is same as the jth column of C. This is how you will write. All right. And so this implies UT same as C and C is BA. So this is how we have written. If there is any problem, any one of you, please ask. Usually, ye proof karne ke liye nahi aata hai. All right. Usually, we are never asked to prove this. In fact, we get a question on this. All right. You get an applicative question on this one. I'll tell you what kind of question you get. But if there is any problem in this, please ask. No problem? Okay, perfect. So let us now take an example to show what type of questions are usually asked. So the question says, you know, in the question you're given U, you are given T also. All right. And you are asked to verify that UT is matrix of U into matrix of T. All right, I have not written alpha, beta, gamma because right now I have not taken the domain and codomain. So let us see what example I want to take. So I'm taking U from P3 R to P2 R. आपको जो हैंडआउट्स दिए हैं उसमें यही एग्जांपल लिया हुआ है, सो प्लीज रेफर टू दैट. एंड आई एम टेकिंग टी टू बी पी टू आर टू पी थ्री आर. ओके, सो यू इज, सो इफ पी थ्री मीन्स वी हैव टू टेक पॉलीनोमियल्स ऑफ डिग्री लेस देन इक्वल टू 3. सो यू एफ एक्स इज एफ डैश एक्स. ओके, एंड टी एफ एक्स is integral 0 to x f t dt. This is how we have defined u and t, and we have to show I am taking alpha and beta to be standard basis. Okay, standard basis for p2 and p3 respectively. All right, so ho sakta maine alag liya ho handout mein. So please don't get confused. Okay, so just refer to this one here. So now if u is this, t is this, what is ut? Ut ka domain hoga ye p2r, so domain of t and codomain of u, so p2r. All right, so I think maine ulta liya hai. I have taken beta in the handout. I've taken beta to be standard basis for p2 and I've taken alpha to be standard basis of p3. All right, so I need to show that ut, now because domain and codomain they are both same, so instead of writing ut beta beta I will only write beta. Agar a ki likha hai, yani domain or codomain same hai. Okay, so I have to show ut beta is equals to, now u ka domain is p3 or p3 ka standard basis I've taken alpha, so alpha beta. And T mate is ulta, beta alpha. Okay, so ye aap please dhyan se likhna, isme gadbad karoge to you will lose marks. All right, so be very careful when you are writing this and this. So now I need to verify this. All right, so to how do we verify this? Verify karne ke liye hum ye nikalenge, ye bhi nikalenge aur ye bhi nikalenge. All right, by direct computations, and then we will show that when we are multiplying these two we are getting this only. All right, so let us see how do we do that. So first we find out u alpha beta. Okay, sabse pehle ye nikalte hain. So to find out u alpha beta, sabse pehle mujhe u alpha nikalna hai. Okay, because I've taken alpha to be standard basis of p3, so alpha would be 1 x square x cube. All right, and beta is standard basis of p2, so it is 1 x square. Okay, so first of all we find out u alpha, so u alpha would be u1 ux ux square ux cube. So u of fx is derivative of fx, so derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of x is 1, derivative of x square is 2x, derivative of x cube is 3x square. Next we write down coordinates with respect to beta. Okay, coordinates with respect to this, so coordinates of 0 with respect to beta, coordinates of 1 with respect to beta, coordinates of 2x with respect to beta, and coordinates of 3x square with respect to beta. Okay, now coordinates of 0 with respect to beta, beta is 1 x x square, it is 0, so it is 0 0 0. Why? Because 0 can be written as 0 into 1 plus 0 into x plus 0 into x square. Okay, so coordinates of 0 with respect to beta is 0 0 0. Coordinates of 1 with respect to beta is 1 0 0. Why? Because 1 can be written as 1 into 1 plus 0 into x plus 0 into x square. Similarly, 2x with respect to beta is 0, 2, 0. Again, because 2x can be written as 0 into 1 plus 2 into x plus 0 into x square. So coordinates with of 3x square with respect to beta is 0, 0, 3. So now having found all of these coordinates, we write down the matrix U. So matrix U alpha beta. Yahi tha? U alpha beta is, so coordinates of this will be first column, second column, third column, fourth column. So I'm writing this down here. So it is 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 0, 3. Alright. So this is matrix of U. Now we find out matrix of T. Can you do it on your own? Main directly likh do. Can I write it directly? Okay. So when we find out the matrix of T, we are getting it to be 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, half 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 by 3. All right. This is what the matrix of T is coming out to be. Okay. So now we need to find out matrix of UT. All right. Isko bhi pehle direct nikalenge. Fir hum dekhenge ki jab main in dono ko multiply kar rahi hu. Look, when I multiply these two, what am I getting? We get, jab in dono ko multiply karoge, it will come out to be identity. Okay. So UT beta should also come out to be identity. So let us see, to find out UT beta, we find out UT of beta first. So that means UT of 1, UT beta is the standard basis of, beta is the standard basis of P2. So UTX, UTX square. Okay. So will you be able to do this on your own? Kar loge? After finding out UT beta, we have to find UT beta ke coordinates with respect to beta. Alright, so it will be UT 1 ke coordinates with respect to beta, UT x ke coordinates with respect to beta, UT x square ke coordinates with respect to beta. Then this will be your first column, this will be your second column, this will be your third column, and you will get it to be 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. I hope you will be able to do this on your own. Please say yes, everyone. Okay. So in another 2 minutes, the meeting will end automatically because it is time. All right. So what I'm doing is I'm ending this meeting and starting it again. You please join. Okay. All right. So next, what we have to do is, now I am taking T to be a linear transformation from V to W. Okay. And where V and W, again, they are finite dimensional vector spaces over the same field F. And I'm assuming that V ka basis is beta and W ka basis is gamma. Okay. And we need to show that if I want to find out coordinates of TU, now TU will be in W. Okay. So if I want to find out coordinates of TU with respect to gamma, then it will be same as matrix T beta gamma into coordinates of U with respect to beta. U is here in V. Okay. Because U belongs to V. So I can talk about coordinates of U with respect to basis of V. So I can talk about this. Okay. TU is in W. So TU is in W. So I can talk about coordinates of TU with respect to basis of W, which is gamma. Okay. So what I am here trying to say is that if I know the coordinates of U, then I can find the coordinates of TU by using the matrix T. All right. So let us see how I'll be proving this. It is given there in the handout, so you can refer. So now what I'm doing is, for a fixed u belonging to V, so I'm fixing this, and for this fixed u, I'm defining two linear transformation F and G. Okay, I'm defining these. So I'm taking F to be from field F to V, and I'm taking G to be from field F to W. Okay, so here I'm taking F of A, because field liya, so it will be scalar here, so I'm taking it to be A. So F of A is, now I have to take an element in V. Now because I've already fixed U in V, so I know U is there in V. So F of A, I've taken A into U. All right, so if U is in V, A is a scalar, so scalar multiplication of U will be in V. All right, so it is well defined. Similarly, here I've defined G of A, again it is from F to W. Now I know only one element in W, which is TU, because U is in V, that implies TU is in W. So here I'm taking this to be ATU, because TU is in W, scalar multiplication of TU will also be in W, so this is also well defined. Is it okay? So this is how I've defined F and G. Now we can see that from definition, look, it is clear that G is equals to TF. Okay, now because, why? Because if I take G of A, all right, and I take TF of A, okay, they will come out to be the same. So T of FA, so FA is AU. Now because T is linear, so I get ATU, which is same as GA. Okay, so that means G is same as TF. All right, so G is equals to TF. I'll be using this. All right, I need to find coordinates of TU with respect to gamma. All right, I need to find coordinates of TU with respect to gamma. Now just see here, what is TU? Is it not G of 1? If I take G, I'm taking A to be 1. So I get G of 1 is 1 into TU, which is same as TU. So that means TU is same as G1. Alright, so TU ke coordinates with respect to gamma is same as G1 ke coordinates with respect to gamma. Alright, I'll be using this now. Let us take this as 1. Let us take this as 2. Now, because I've taken F to be field, alright, I've taken F to be field, it can easily be shown that both of these are linear transformations, okay? I have taken F to be field. So field ka basis kya hota hai? Is it not singleton one? Multiplicative identity, okay? Singleton one is my standard basis for F. Okay, singleton one is the standard basis for F. Now, agar mujhe G ke matrix ki baat karni hai, if I want to talk about G ka matrix, it will be with respect to this. I'm taking this to be alpha, okay? So, it will be alpha here, domain, and codomain is that of W, all right? W ka basis kya hai? W ka basis is kangya, gamma. Is it okay? So, if I want to talk about this, तो मुझे कैसे करना पड़ेगा? I want to find out G alpha first, right? Now G alpha is what? Alpha is only 1, so it is G of 1, right? So because alpha is singleton 1, so there is only 1 vector, all right? So G of alpha will be G of 1, okay? Now G of alpha is G of 1. So I want to find out G alpha gamma. This is what I'm doing. Alpha was singleton 1. To find this out, I find out G alpha first, which is G of 1. Then I find out G alpha ke coordinates with respect to gamma. That means G1 ke coordinates with respect to gamma, right? And because there is only one vector, so this vector will be the column, first column and the only column of G. So that means this matrix G alpha gamma is nothing but जी वन के कोऑर्डिनेट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू गामा. इज दिस क्लियर? एनीबडी एनी प्रॉब्लम प्लीज आस्क. Anybody, any problem, please ask. I have just used the steps to find the matrix of a linear transformation. All right, I was trying to find this out. Alpha is singleton 1. So I first have to find out G alpha. So G alpha will be G of 1. Then I need to find out G alpha ke coordinates with respect to gamma. So G alpha ke coordinates with respect to gamma would be G1 ke coordinates with respect to gamma. And this will be my first and the only column of G because there is no other vector here. All right. So my matrix G is equal to this column vector. This is what I have written. I hope it is clear to all of you. I have already taken 1 and 2. So now what I am doing is if I take a look at the second equation that I had taken, I had written that TU के कोऑर्डिनेट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू गामा इज जी वन के कोऑर्डिनेट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू गामा. दिस वाज इक्वेशन टू. नाउ आई हैव सेड दैट दिस इज सेम एज दिस. ऑलराइट, सो दिस इज जी अल्फा गामा. ओके, नाउ इक्वेशन वन में मैंने बोला था दैट जी इज इक्वल्स टू टी एफ. दिस वाज इक्वेशन वन. सो जी की जगह आई विल पुट टी एफ. ऑलराइट, so now T is a linear transformation, F is a linear transformation. So again, UT ka matrix is U ka matrix into T ka matrix. So this would be T ka matrix into F ka matrix. All right, F ka matrix is alpha to beta, T ka matrix is beta to gamma. You can check. So we get this. Now again, I am leaving it here now. I am taking equation 4. जैसे ये किया था वैसे ही now we'll find out F alpha beta. Okay, so F alpha beta, again alpha is only singleton 1. So जैसे पहले किया था exactly this I will get. I will get F alpha beta to be F of 1 with respect to beta. This is what I will get. Okay, so putting it here, I get T gamma beta. So instead of this, I put F of 1 ke coordinates with respect to beta. But what is F of 1? If we take a look at how we had defined F. Okay, so F was defined as F of A is equals to AU. So F of 1 is only U. So F of 1 is U. So we get T beta gamma U beta. This is what we were supposed to prove. We were supposed to prove that coordinates of T U with respect to gamma is same as matrix T into coordinates of U with respect to beta. If there is any problem, any one of you, please ask. It is clear to everyone? Okay. So let us now move on. Now what I'll do is, again, ये जो मैंने अभी आपको करवाया है, ये भी as such proof करने के लिए नहीं आता है. What you get is, you get a question on this, and in the question, what happens is they give you a linear transformation. So they give you a linear transformation T. All right. And they'll give you a vector u. And they'll ask you to find tu ke coordinates by using this. Okay? Or they will ask you to verify this. This is how you get a question. Alright? So let us just take a look. Again, I'm taking t from p3r to p2r. Okay? Again, I'm taking this to be t of fx is equals to f dash x derivative. Okay, I am taking u to be 2 minus, because u is an element in domain. Okay, so u is a polynomial of degree less than equal to 3. So I am taking it to be 2 minus 4x plus x square plus 3x cube. So ye question mein diya hota hai aapko, and you are asked to verify that this is true. So tu with respect to, and now I am taking b beta to be standard basis of this, and I'm taking gamma to be standard basis of P to R. Okay, and I have to show that TU gamma is equals to beta, gamma, and beta. Okay, so this I have to verify. So how do we do it? I will just quickly tell you. We first find out matrix of T with respect to beta, gamma. All right. अभी हमने पहले भी इसका matrix find out किया है. So I am writing it straight away. Differential है ये. Okay. So the matrix came out to be 0, 0, 0 derivative वाला. 1, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 0, 3. So this was my matrix T. All right. Now U is this. Beta and gamma are standard basis. So U beta. Beta is standard, okay? Beta is my standard basis of P3. So 1, x, x square, x cube. And gamma is standard basis of P2. So 1, x, x square. So U beta, coordinates of U with respect to this basis is nothing but the coefficients 2, minus 4, 1, 3. Okay, so this is U beta. Now we find out TU. Now what is TU? TU is derivative of U. Okay. So derivative of this is minus 4 plus 2x plus 9x square. Okay. So derivative now TU ke coordinates with respect to the standard basis gamma is what? Minus 4, 2, 9. Okay. So we have got this. We have got this. We have got this. Now we'll multiply. So we have LHS already. We'll multiply these two and we'll see that we are getting it to be this. Okay, this is how you have to do it. I hope you will be able to complete it on your own. The result is given in the handout that is given to you. If there is any problem, any one of you, please ask. Unmute everyone. Everybody, please unmute. It says that if V is any vector space, okay, then we have to find out all linear transformations from V to V such that T square is same as T. Okay, we need to find out all the linear transformations such that T square is equals to T. So let us see. So I'll take T to be any linear transformation from V to V such that T square is T. So now I need to see what kind of transformations will I get. All right. So now what I'm doing is, let us take any X belonging to V, because T is a linear transformation from V to V. So I'm taking an element of domain. I want to see how T is acting on this element. Okay. This is why I've taken X belonging to V. So now X can be written as Tx plus x minus tx. Okay, I've just added and subtracted tx. Okay, so now what I am doing is I have written, basically I've decomposed x. Okay, so if I take a look, this element belongs to range, right? And this element belongs to kernel of T. How it belongs to kernel, let us see. Kernel mein belong karne ka condition kya hota hai? T of this element should be 0. So let us see what is T of this element. So T of x minus Tx, when I see, it comes out to be Tx, because T is linear, to alag alag kar rahi hu, minus T square x. Okay, but T square is same as T. So this is Tx minus Tx, which is 0. Okay, now because T of this element is 0, that means this element here belongs to kernel. So this belongs to kernel. So that means any element in V can be written as sum of an element in range plus an element in kernel. So that means V is RT plus NT. Is it okay? It is only possible when T square is T. So when T square is T, so V will come out to be range T plus kernel T. Okay, let us further see now. Now, if I take an element in intersection of RT and NT, so let me take X belongs to RT intersection NT. Okay, let X की जगह Y ले लेती हूँ, because मैंने पहले X लिया था, आप confused ना हो जो. So if Y belongs to the intersection, what will happen? Y belongs to range and Y belongs to kernel. Okay, now because Y belongs to range, that means Y can be written as T of Z for some Z belonging to V. Okay, and because Y belongs to kernel, so that means T of Y is equals to, yes? Yes, Neha? Yes, Neha? मेरी आवाज नहीं आ रही, दोबारा रिपीट करो सारा. Neha, can you hear me now? Others, can you hear me? Please unmute and tell me. Can you people hear me? Please unmute and tell me if you can hear me.